Most people think that setting up a VPN on a router is only for tech experts. Spoiler alert, it's not, and I'm gonna prove it to you in this VPN for router tutorial. Let's get started. So, what does using a VPN on a router actually do, and what are the added advantages to daily life? Now, the VPN itself protects the connection of any device that it's installed on by creating a protective bubble around your network and all the data inside of it. But what happens if you want to protect your device that can't support a VPN? Well, that's where having a VPN router saves the day. By installing the VPN directly onto the router itself, every device that's connected to it instantly gains its protective powers. And since hackers these days are able to tap into basically anything, from smart fridges to baby monitors and gaming systems, it's just crucial to secure those as well. And since most providers have a limit on how many devices you can simultaneously use your VPN on, using a VPN for a router lets you protect all your devices that are connected to Wi-Fi, even for your guests. Not to mention, how great is it to bypass ISP throttling now that your internet service provider can no longer see your online activity? Now, with that being said, what are the basic requirements to get a VPN router set up? Well, first thing you need is a VPN from a provider that supports router installations. And my top three best VPN for router picks that do this are NordVPN, Surfshark, and Proton. They all offer great deals and lots of additional features. So to grab the best coupon code for any of these subscriptions, just be sure to follow the link in the description. Aside from having a VPN, the next thing you're gonna need is a compatible router, and ideally one that isn't locked by your internet service provider. Unfortunately, most ISPs don't support VPN use, so this could mean needing to replace your current one or use a second one that includes support. Now, I've always found that ASUS routers are great for this kind of job. Now, once you have a VPN subscription and a router that can support it, the final thing you're gonna need is the correct firmware. Some routers do support VPNs out of the box. However, if yours doesn't, then you can opt for either DDWRT or OpenWRT firmware as an alternative. Now, all three of these providers include a step-by-step guide on their websites showing users how to install VPN on router. But just to give you an idea of the process, I'll do a demo using NordVPN on my ASUS router. After logging into the control panel, you'll want to click the VPN button on the lower left side, then hit VPN client, and after that, add profile. Once you see the pop-up window, press the Open VPN tab, fill out the empty fields, and click OK. Then all that's left to do is download the OpenVPN configuration files, and the ASUS VPN router setup is complete. If you're using a DDWRT router, then NordVPN also has a straightforward guide to configure those OpenVPN under the DDWRT administrative interface. Navigate to Setup, then Basic Setup. Next, you'll want to make sure all the fields in the network address server settings match the ones written on the NordVPN guide, and press Save and Apply Settings. Now, all that's left to do is go to the Setups tab, then click the Disable button under the IPv6, plus Save and Apply Settings Now. Navigate to Service and VPN, and under OpenVPN Client, press Start OpenVPN Client. I know this is a quick rundown, but if you'd like to see a more detailed tutorial, then feel free to check out the video that I've left on screen or follow the help articles from today's providers. And if you do find that your router is not compatible out of the box and need an alternative solution, then it's worth noting that some models can potentially be modified into DDWRT or OpenWRT. This process is definitely suited for more advanced users, and you run the risk of voiding the warranty or bricking the router altogether. You can use the QR code on screen for NordVPN or follow the links in the description to get any of my other best VPN recommendations at the lowest possible price. All right, once you've chosen your best VPN for a router and configured everything, what are the benefits you'll now have? A front runner in this category is the immediate access to international streaming content anytime you switch server locations. I mean, I found that all of today's VPNs had no problem accessing content from the most popular streaming platforms out there, even on smart TVs that by default aren't able to support VPN apps. On that note, my torrenting experience was also secure and successful. Keep in mind though, there is likely gonna be a speed drop. The reason for this is simply because VPN speeds on routers are often slower than what you would get if the app was directly on a device. However, if you have a good router, then the speed drop should be less noticeable. For those of you who prioritize fast speeds, I do suggest using Surfshark or ProtonVPN, as they offer WireGuard connection instead of OpenVPN. NordVPN actually does offer the fast protocol of the bunch, NordLynx. However, it's currently only available on Privacy Hero routers specifically. If you don't have one of those, then stick to the industry standard OpenVPN option. Security-wise, all three VPNs offer top-tier encryption that'll keep your network safe from outside threats. Now, NordVPN and Proton both have privacy-friendly jurisdictions. And while Surfshark is based in the Netherlands, which is a Nine Eyes Alliance member, the company's no-logs policy has been audited multiple times, so it's not an issue. On that note, NordVPN and Proton also have audited no-logs policies, making them really secure options. Additionally, NordVPN and Surfshark have RAM-only servers that wipe data clean after each reboot. And Proton offers encrypted disks to keep your data safe, even if a server is compromised. And as far as variety goes, all of these best VPN providers have vast server fleets and lots of locations to choose from. Surfshark has 3,200 servers in 100 countries. NordVPN has over 7,400 servers in 118 locations. And Proton's fleet consists of an impressive 12,000 plus servers across 117 countries. So as you can see, adding a VPN to your router comes with plenty of benefits. Not only does it allow you to essentially cover an infinite amount of devices, but it can also protect ones that don't natively support VPNs. This is great for families or shared homes, especially those who want assurance that the VPN connection is always enabled. And of course, it's super useful for bypassing any geo-restricted content for websites. The main drawbacks that I've encountered when using a VPN on my router is that there's now an extra step required to change the server or protocol. And as I mentioned earlier, the speed is a little slower, especially on older models. Router compatibility can also be an issue, and the setup process can feel challenging, particularly for those who aren't experienced. Now, aside from those things, having a VPN on router does bring massive amounts of security and variety to your online experience in one fell swoop, really. So once you pick the provider for you, check the description for links with the lowest possible pricing so you can start protecting all your household devices. And I promise it's not as hard as it seems. So to sum everything up, using any one of the best VPN providers on your router will keep your devices safe and protected at all times, even if they can't support a VPN app. Yes, it may take a little time to set up and might slow things down, but once it's up and running, yeah, it makes staying safe super easy. All right, thanks for watching. I'll see you in the next one. Bye.